Welcome back to Buckeye Bigfoot. Hello, everyone. Well, I hope you're all doing well this week. Now, I told you last week that the Sunshine Coast stories would continue tonight, and they are. But I just want to clarify a small mistake I made. My brain did that thing last week where you've been talking to someone and it inserts the name of that person over someone else's name. And that's exactly what happened last week. I said the Sunshine Coast stories would be returning from Steve's stories. I called him Steve. Steve is not his name. It's Jonathan. I know it's Jonathan. But I had just been speaking to a friend named Steve, and I was supposed to call him back. And anyway, my brain made a fudgy. So I just want to correct that. It's Jonathan. So Jonathan's encounter tonight has some very unusual elements in it. So grab your ration of snacks, and yes, please do ration those snacks. I don't want any of you to run out if you are sheltering at home. Anyway, grab those snacks and let's get started. This is the first of many encounters at the family cabin on a remote lake, the north end of Sunshine Coast. I've had more than half a dozen encounters with the wild people of the forests, Sasquatch. And at this point in my life, from single males, small family groups, to young juveniles messing around. But nothing like what took place in the encounter I am about to share with you. It blew my mind like none of my previous encounters. We were about to start a new season with our kayak crew, and my business partner, co-owner, and CEO decided to start our season off with a fun weekend at the family cabin for all of our employees before our new kayak season began on June 15th. My business partner and CEO traveled from Vancouver, British Columbia, up to the Sunshine Coast to meet the employees at the family cabin for our fun weekend. I was on the next ferry after my business partner, which put me a couple of hours behind her and the employees to arrive at the cabin. So when I arrived, everyone was already settled in, enjoying some sun, tanning, swimming, fishing, and lounging on the deck. I said hello to all and chatted with different employees, families, and friends. I made my way down by the lake, where there were several kayaks, paddle boards, fishing rods, and a dock to swim and dive off. I was having a conversation with one of the employees at the shoreline when I heard a chirping call come from the back of the lake. It was very loud, for the back of the lake is almost a mile away from the cabin. The chirping sound I heard sounds exactly like a woodpecker, but much louder. I've experienced it before on previous encounters with the wild ones. I said, "Excuse me," to the employee that I was chatting with, and said I was going to go for a rip in the kayak. The kayak I chose was aqua blue and a little faded. I was wearing a green tank top. This is important information. I'll explain shortly. I get in the kayak and start across the lake. I reach the other side of a small bay when I could hear large branches being broken in different locations on the back side of the lake, opposite the side I was on. So I move close to the shoreline, which is covered with a bush called salal, and grows almost to the waterline. I am now halfway to the back of the lake on the north side. The branches are still being broken on the south side. I'm moving very slowly and quietly hugging the shoreline. I am now three-quarters of the way to the back. I see something, big and dark brown, almost black in color, standing in the water on the south shore at the back end. I make my way around the back end and start coming around to where this thing was standing in the water. As I did, we were not visible to one another. As I get closer, I'm hearing talking, more like chattering, and branches still being broken. There's movement through the bushes along the shoreline for like 50 yards just up in front of me. I came out around a little outcrop to where whatever it was standing in the water would have been and still was. There he was, a large male Sasquatch, 9 to 10 feet tall, trying to break off this large branch about 4 inches in diameter off a tree that was submerged underwater. He was facing the shore and had no idea I had snuck up behind him about 20 feet. I bumped the right side of the kayak with the paddle accidentally, alerting him to my presence. He stopped pulling on the branch, stood up straight, and paused. He was not alone. Not at all. I am now starting to realize there are multiple Sasquatch all along the shore right in front of me. Little ones, juveniles, males, and a female one for sure. They are all now aware I'm there, and vice versa. The big male in the water in front of me glanced to the right. A couple of Sasquatch stood up to the left at the shoreline and walked slowly and sheepishly back up into the woods. I believe they were supposed to be lookouts for any danger, and they missed me going right by them. But again, vice versa, for I didn't know they were there either, visually anyway. The big guy then just walked up and out of the water, up into the tree line, never looking back at me, not once the whole time. But when he glanced to the left, I could see a part of the left side of his face. His skin was a grayish charcoal color. I could see a couple of juveniles up in trees, two or three out in the open to my left, sitting in the salal bush, exposed from the waist up, and some little ones sitting on a grassy area just to the right of me. One small one that was toddler or infant-sized, the others a bit bigger, like a 1 or 2-year-old sitting with 3, 5, or 6-year-old kids. The little one didn't know I was there, for the little one was still patty-cake-type play-smacking the ground. It now realizes I'm right there in front of them all, then lets out the chirping sound that sounds like a woodpecker. Then there was a verbal response 25 yards to my right that was much louder by far, but the exact same chirping noise. I then hear one that was large and coming fast through the woods toward the toddler. Sounded like a freight train. It was the mother. There was a log laying across the shoreline behind the young ones, about 4 feet high. The mother was now standing on the other side of the log. She was probably just over 7 feet tall and easily north of 500 pounds and very muscular. She had breasts covered with hair. She looked just like Patty in the Patterson-Gimlin film. One of the older ones beside the baby that cried out grabbed the smaller one and hoisted it over the log into its mother's arms. But the baby climbed up the side, then back of the older one, over the shoulder, grabbing the hair of it as it climbed into its mommy's arms. Then the other young ones jumped over the log. They all retreated back into safety of tree line and bushes. As she walked away with the little one in her arms, she stared at me the whole time. Identical to the Memorial Day Bigfoot with Baby video on YouTube. This was all just blowing my mind. What am I witnessing? Some moved behind trees, some back up into the tree line, some just ducked down, and others just froze in place. This all happens in just a couple of minutes at most. Nobody's moving now. It's dead quiet. We are all just staring at each other. My heart is racing. I could literally hear and feel my own heart pounding in my chest. Felt like my heart was going to burst through my chest plate. Remember, my shirt was green tank top and my kayak was aqua blue. I believe this gave me the perfect camouflage as I came around the lake to where they were. And being so close to shoreline, also my experience with a kayak, I can move without making a sound, literally. 15 to 20 minutes go by of us just staring at each other before they realized I was not an immediate threat and started to feel comfortable to move around again. Cautiously, they did just that. I was taking photos and video on and off since I snuck up behind the big male in the water. I had a Samsung Galaxy S5. It did not have zoom on it, and the lighting feature was not on the right setting more than likely. The photos show dark figures all over where they were as I took the photos, but no real clarity to them, of course, right? The best would have been the video I had taken as I came up behind the big male in the water, but I had accidentally deleted it afterwards going through them while the encounter was still taking place. I was so angry, but I thought, just take another video, so I did. I sat with them for easily 2 hours plus all together. I talked to them, saying I meant them no harm and was honored to be in their presence. As I watch them mill around for quite some time, I see a very large male moving to my left, closer to me, and then stands behind a giant cedar tree at the shoreline. The same thing happened on my right. Another large male moved from behind one tree to another. I still had visuals on many others. These two big males were much larger than the male in the water, which is the biggest I had seen by far. They were at least 3 feet taller, putting them both 12 to 13 feet tall. I had no idea they could get so big. Didn't think it was possible. Nor did I think there would be a group this large in numbers, 12 to 16 at least. All different ages and sizes, even different colors. Some were black-grayish, some were brown to auburn, all very similar to Patty. The two others I've seen up close in previous encounters looked more human in the face. They looked just like a giant human man with hair. Nothing ape-like about them. This large group had a hint of ape-like qualities. Wide nose, larger gap between lip and nose, conical shape to the head. It is now starting to get dark. I'm so entrenched in taking all of this in. I didn't even notice this until I start to hear my name being called out. Jonathan, Jonathan, are you okay? It was some of my family members and employees coming across the lake in 3 kayaks to find me. I was gone for so long, and dark was setting in fast now. I snapped out of my trance and realized it was now evening. I faced my kayak towards them, and I yelled out that I was in back end of the lake, and I was all right. I was saying goodbye to the Sasquatch clan and gave thanks for the encounter. I believe the one in the water was their leader, or alpha male, even though there were 2 bigger males in the group. As I started paddling away from them, he came back down by the shore. As I was leaving, there was something that happened between him and I that makes me question everything I thought I knew about them. I am not ready to say what it was that happened. I will tell you this. I've always believed them to live, breathe, and bleed, and they are born and they die as humans do, and that they are from Earth. What happened was so profound I deny or ignore this part of this amazing encounter myself, at least until I can figure out what and why this unique incident took place. This was 2014. I've had many encounters at the cabin and lake since that day over the next 3 or 4 years, which I will share down the road here on Buckeye Bigfoot. 10 days later, I returned to the cabin. A couple days off from work, and I have an up-close and brief encounter with a mama and her baby. I believe it was the same two that I had seen in this encounter shared here before you. The cabin is a very special place with amazing inhabitants. Looking forward to returning this spring and summer. Thank you for listening. Love Buckeye Bigfoot and the Sasquad. Well, everyone, I don't know about you all, but to me, that is one wild encounter. I have so many questions, and I know you all do too. But the good news is that Jonathan is a subscriber here, and on all the other Sunshine Coast stories, he has been available to answer a lot of questions and to talk with people in the comments. And I feel pretty certain he'll be around tonight too. And by the way, to let you know, Jonathan did send me a photo. But when I pulled it from his email, it was very small and I can't upsize it to fit for the video, or it just looks all distorted. But I'm going to go ahead and show you what it looks like here, and this is the size I got it in. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I can't see anything in this picture other than a dark shoreline with trees. Again, I'm no authority and I wasn't there. I'm not a researcher that collects evidence. I'm just sharing with you the picture he shared with me. But all of this is interesting to me nonetheless. I like the idea of maybe a large clan of Sasquatch living together. It kind of makes sense, as there's safety in numbers. I found this unusual because almost every other encounter I've ever had sent in is mostly an encounter with 1 or maybe 2 Sasquatch. But a whole group? That's pretty interesting to me. And if you're wondering, yes, I am in Ohio, and yes, I am sheltering at home per the governor's orders, and I am not working. So, if I get more encounters rolling in during this time period, I will try to put out more stories to keep you all entertained through all of this, because I'm pretty sure everyone in every state will be going through this at some point. And what better thing to do while stuck in the house than to listen to some Bigfoot encounters? You just make sure you're stocked up on those snacks. Me? I'm a baker, so I'm baking a variety of Squatch snacks for us. So, if you've got a story you'd like to share, send me an email at contact@buckeyebigfoot.com, then we can all share your experience. Well, that's it for tonight. I'm Nance Warren, and I don't think I'll be sassing at it at all this week. I'm staying home, and I'm staying healthy, and I highly suggest and hope that the Sass Squad does the same. Until next time, always remember, absence of proof is not proof of absence. Thanks for listening, everyone. If you like what you've heard and want to hear more, hit the like and subscribe button, and don't forget the bell to get notifications.